For the past few months, I've been studying from home. I'm currently a third-year medical student in the United States, which means that now I'm starting my clinical rotations. The way it works is that I spend a couple of weeks at a time in the clinic or hospital, and shortly afterwards, I'll take a shelf exam based on the clinical knowledge from that block. And this process repeats for each rotation. But since the start of our rotations was perfectly timed with quarantine, I instead will be studying and taking these exams from home until we're allowed back into the hospital later in the summer. So today, I thought I'd share with you what my life is currently like as a third-year medical student in lockdown. Next Friday, I have my shelf exam for pediatrics, so I have a lot of material to go over. So each day this week and next week, I have a few hours of mandatory online lectures to attend via Zoom. I opened up the PowerPoints in GoodNotes 5, which is my favorite iPad note-taking app, and all I'm doing is really just grabbing the high-yield information from these lectures, jotting them down so that I can transfer them to my flashcards later on. A lot of people say that lockdown has forced them to change their study habits around, but for me, I never really went to class anyways. I was much more of a podcast person, so it really didn't change much of my workflow. So one of the nice things about online lectures is that I don't have to sit at my desk the whole time, so I'm just gonna go make some coffee because I'm still listening. I definitely think the initial shock from lockdown has settled down. Sure, things have been unusual, but it doesn't feel crazy anymore, right? Like, I haven't seen my best friends who I used to see on a daily basis. I think I've completely forgotten how to drive a car at this point. I've been spending a lot more time with my siblings, more than I have in years, and I've gotten pretty dang good at 2K. I guess what I mean is that with time, all things begin to feel normal. Life just carries on. I recently read Barry Schwartz's The Paradox of Choice, and he talks about this really fascinating study about the way that people tend to regress to feeling normal. I guess in psychology, it would be called adaptation. But basically, when an impactful event occurs, like the pandemic or these riots, for instance, we feel like our lives are uprooted. But if the event keeps going on after a week or two, things start to feel pretty normal again, just another day. We're programmed as creatures of habit. We like finding a rhythm and consistency. But things aren't actually normal, right? They just feel normal. And that's when I realized something really important. Right when things start to change dramatically and people's opinions start to shift, that's the moment that we all have to start working together to rebuild positive changes and fight for things that we care about. Because that way, when we reach our new norm and things settle down, fighting for justice and equality will feel like the normal thing to do. Anyway, I digress. Time to get back to studying. So now I'm going to spend a good chunk of time doing practice questions from New World and transferring all the important information into RemNote, which is my favorite study app. It's an app that generates flashcards with spaced repetition while I take notes. And I'm also going to be transferring all the important information from this morning from GoodNotes right into RemNote too. So Mike just texted me that he's getting home a little early from work today, which is awesome. And some spots in LA have recently opened up, finally, for the first time in a couple months. So we're gonna be brave and venture out and go get some food and support our local businesses.
Yo.
Hey, what's up?
You're back earlier today, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Ready to go?
It's actually such a beautiful day out, so we're just walking over to get some food from this place called Public School. First time going out to eat in like 2 months, so pretty excited for this.
So tonight, Mike and I wanted to go out and get some drinks and eat some food because some places in LA started to open up again. But something pretty unexpected happened.
We got the curfew. We finished the lockdown, now we get the curfew.
So I guess it's kind of destiny telling us that we have to go back and study. I mean, we both ended up wearing these two when we went out, so it's kind of our own fault, I guess. So we studied. But during our hardcore, laser-focused session, the curfew got me thinking more about all the changes taking place and the idea from the paradox of choice about our tendency to establish a new norm. So we just had a few thoughts we wanted to share as we wrap up this video.
To be frank, I 100% support freedom of speech. Peaceful protest is a human right that should be respected, so I hope this movement will continue to inspire change and bring us to a new norm, because this is the time that we have to make those changes stick.
But everything comes at a cost, because as we strive for a new norm, we also have to be mindful of all the progress that we've made in the past few months in containing the global pandemic as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how's that been going for you, working on the front lines?
Pretty good. I've been working in the hospital alongside other healthcare workers and essential workers, and they've all been making their own sacrifices. They come to work so that some of us can stay home. But when the protest started, you can't deny that we probably broke social distancing a little too quickly. And we already know that the initial COVID wave hit the poorest communities the hardest. Like, they have worse outcomes because they already start behind, they have less access to care, they have more illnesses.
Yeah, and then you throw coronavirus in there too.
Yeah, exactly. And what makes me anxious is that if a new second COVID wave comes out of these protests, it will inevitably hit the poorest communities the hardest again.
Yeah, those social determinants of health, man. It's really crazy how even COVID treats our communities unfairly.
Yeah, but like you said, hopefully we're reaching a new norm and that we end up better than where we started. And I just hope that everyone out there is staying safe, wear your masks, wash your hands, both protesters and cops, and just try to look out for each other.
There's no quick fix to this problem. And to be honest, Mike and I don't have any answers ourselves, but all we can do is keep spreading awareness and keep talking about it. Anyways, thanks for following along with me today. Hopefully you got a feel of what it's like to be a medical student in lockdown right now, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
I hope you enjoyed that video. Give it a thumbs up because it really helps us out. And if you want to see more, click on the red subscribe button down here or the circle up here.
Check out our website or check out our Instagram, links in the description below. And check out these videos over here. We think you might enjoy them.
And we'll see you next time.